Tina here. Welcome to PhotoPlay's YouTube channel and welcome to Tuesdays with Tina. I'm back today and today we are going to create a little sunshine with the fall season around the corner. We've been getting some hit and misses with sunshine, so I'm bringing in the beautiful Say It With Stamps sunflower stamp set. It's a large 6x8 stamp set. It does have a coordinating die set that will cut out some of the sentiments in your set also, which I like because I like layers, and when you have a coordinating die that cut out some of your sentiments, you can pop it up, and that's what I like to do. So we're going to use this, and we're going to pair this with the coordinating stencil set. This is a 6-piece, 6x9 stencil that you can use to color in your images. Now you don't have to stamp and color in, you can use the stencil on its own, which is great. But we're gonna speed up the coloring process. Sometimes coloring in images with alcohol markers takes a little bit of time, but if you wanna mass produce, this is a great way to do it with the color in your images with stencil. Let's jump in and get started. I'm gonna do something a little bit different because the stencils are all indexed on top. There's 6 of them again. They're A through F, and you don't have to necessarily go by the order, but what I'm gonna do is start with my leaf base. So this is actually stencil E, and we are gonna use the stamp set, but bear with me. I'm gonna use this as a guide for marking it on my cardstock. Let me grab a piece of cardstock that's long. The cardstock that I'm using is the Say It With Stamps Color Me Premium cardstock. I love this for ink blending. But I'm going to add a little bit of Pixie Spray. It's a low-tack adhesive behind my stencil. The flower that we're going to be using for today's card is this one here. I love the single sunflower. I'm partial to sunflowers because I live in the sunflower state. But I added a little of Pixie Spray because it's a low-tack adhesive. And I'm going to place this on my cardstock panel in the corner. I'm going to go here to here. This way, with all of my layers, I can start in the corner and they're going to be perfectly lined up. I need a guide to where to stamp my sunflower, so this is going to give me the perfect guide because it has the flower center and it also has the leaf. So this is again layer E. So since my sunflower center and the leaves are different colors, I'm going to use my finger daubers to color them in. The ink, I'm going to be using two shades for my leaves and two shades for my flower centers. Two shades of brown and two shades of green. My lightest green will go with this layer here. And so let's grab our finger dauber. And I'm just gonna pick up the ink and go over the leaf area. And then I'm going to use my lightest brown ink to go over the flower center. Like so. Pretty easy peasy so far, right? Now, if you guys know me, you know I like to wipe my stencils off while they're on the cardstock. So I wiped it off, and now what we're going to do is remove our stencil. Like so. For this next part, I'm going to zoom in. And then we're going to open up our stamp set and take the image that's in our stamp. And then I'm going to line this up over my floral image, like so. Now I have a little extra room on the top. I'm going to use my scissors and trim that away. This way, just a little bit away. This way I can put this in my stamping positioner. I'm going to press down really good. And I know it's lined up. And then I'm going to treat my paper with my anti-static powder tool. Now I'm going to take a sticky ink. This is a pigment ink that stays sticky or stays wet longer on your stamp. And we're going to heat emboss with this ink. So I'll ink up my beautiful sunflower. Probably need a little more on there. And then we can stamp right over our stenciled area. Wonderful. And then I'm going to bring in some clear embossing powder and we're going to go over this. I'm going to go ahead and melt this now. I think that looks all nice and melted. And while, you know, this would make a great daisy too. Just saying, doesn't it look like a pretty daisy? while we're at it, I'm going to stamp my sentiment, which is going to be the one that says, your courage inspires me. Such a pretty sentiment. So we have our sentiment that's a heat embossed, and then we also have our sunflower that's heat embossed. This way, any ink that goes on the top, we can just wipe away. And our floral is perfectly positioned, so our stenciling is going to be super easy. And again, like I said, this is great for mass producing. Since we already have our leaves and our flower center, our first step then, we're going to finish off with stencil F and finish off the leaves and then also our flower center. So we'll line this up, and I don't have to fuss with the placement because all I have to do is line it up edge to edge. There we go. So if it lines up straight on the bottom in here, it's already lined up perfectly for me. Now, I'm going to take my darker green ink, and then we're going to go over our leaves. That's our darker green ink, and then over our flower center, I'm going to take my darker brown ink. And we're going to go over this. Wonderful. And then we can zoom in. I'm going to zoom in a little bit better when we do the rest of this. So now we can remove our stencil. And we have the detailed all ready to go. So next, we're going to go ahead and do our layers. There's four flower layers. And I'm going to take Stencil C is the layer that has the most petals. I'm going to line it up, kind of a toss between these two. Let's see. I'm going to use my lightest ink and go over the main part of our flower petals. We'll just cover them here. Wipe off our stencil, and then we're going to bring in our next layer. I'm going to find the one that has the next amount of petals showing. Now we line this up. Good to go. Very easy because we already figured out our border. And then for this one, we're going to use a slightly darker yellow ink. I love when the stencils do the coloring for you. You don't have to worry about shading. Sometimes I have a problem finding my shading. I went over it with my second yellow ink. And then we can go ahead and lift this up. Gosh, it's looking so pretty. Now we have two stencils left. So we're going to find the one that has the most surface area next, which would be this one. And then we'll add this. So we have this one. This one I had to lift it a little bit. You might have to adjust it just a bit, but I had to lift it a little bit. So now we're going to add our third color. For me, I'm going to use the orangey kind of a yellow ink. We'll go over this. We can remove our third color. How pretty is that? Now we have just the highlights, and this is the area that has the less surface to go over. For this, we'll use our next color. This is kind of a yellowy, orangey color. And we're gonna go over this. And we get to do the reveal. Are you ready? How easy was it to color in this flower? Gorgeous. So pretty. Love the way this looks. And our sentiment's good to go. So just using four inks, we colored in two for the leaves, two for the flower centers. We created a really fast and pretty flower. Let's go ahead and take the coordinating dies and die cut out our flower. Now, while I have my die, while I'm doing my die cutting, I'm going to also bring in another die set to help me create my background. And we are going to use the Say It With Stamps Nested A2 Arches. I'm going to create an arch. Let's see here, and then this one. Okay, I think that's going to work good. We're going to use some pattern paper. I'm using the Fall Plaids. Love this. I love plaids anyway, and this is a great paper pad. It's kind of one of those fall staples. I'm going to use this for my background. I think it's going to go really good with my flower. Okay, so I picked three of the pattern papers from the Say It With Stamps Fall Plaids 6x6 paper pad. This one I'm going to trim down so it fits my card front. And then this one, I'm going to create a background with one of my Say It With Stamps A2 nested arches. So this will be this, and then I'm going to take the slightly smaller nested arch and die cut this out with the yellow gingham paper. And I am going to pop this panel up, and even though this is nice heavyweight pattern paper, I'm going to also die cut out the same arch with some white cardstock, just to give it a little bit of stability, because I'm gonna put some ribbon around it too. So I have some die cutting to do. I'll be right back. So I went ahead and die cut everything out, and now we get to create our card. I went ahead and trimmed down a panel that was 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 inches with this plaid paper. So that's already on our card base, good to go. And we're gonna go ahead and take this and flip it around. Ooh, and you know what? I think I like the dark brown better. Sometimes with pattern papers, we do that. Yes. So let's use the dark brown versus the light brown. We're going to just kind of switch things up a little bit. That's a happy accident. Don't you love happy accidents? I'm going to place this on the white. I mentioned before we're going to pop this up with foam adhesive. And this is just going to give me extra stability. After we have this adhered, we're going to take this archway, add some adhesive behind it, and we're going to place this right in the center, like so. And then I have some twine. Before I add my twine, I did put some fun foam, some foam adhesive behind this archway. I'm not sure if I want my bow to be on the left or on the right, so we are going to put it in the middle, like so. We'll just tack it down to the back, leaving the ends extra long. Then we can take this, put it in the center of our card base. And I think that I like the brown better. That's a happy accident. Now we're going to take our flower, and I'll place it where I want it on my panel. I think this is a good spot for my sunflower. This way I can tie a bow off to the left, and I'm gonna make sure the knot is right over the stem. So we have our bow tied. I'm gonna trim the tails of my twine. And then we have our sentiment. I want my sentiment to overlap the petals on top here, or maybe over here. So I only put foam adhesive on half of my sentiment. This way it's nice and even with my sunflower. And then on the other half, I'm gonna add some adhesive to it. And then we can just go ahead and layer our sentiment. I think that's a good spot, right above our twine. To balance out the white in my card, we have a white bow and white on our sentiment. I'm gonna take my white gel pen and we're gonna add some white dots to the center of our sunflower. Let me zoom in a little bit. I'm gonna be using some crystal drops for my shimmer today, and I'm gonna just add a few here and there. I think that's like the perfect amount. And that will finish off my card today using the Say It With Stamps Sunflower stamp set along with the Say It With Stamps Sunflower stencil set. So easy to color in your images, and I think it has some pretty fabulous inspirational sentiments too. Have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for joining me. We will see you again soon.